Hello everyone, welcome to AptiPlace Academy for Civil Services. This is a video on daily news and editorial analysis which I'll be covering from the Hindu and Indian Express. So the most important news and editorial would be discussed in this session. Let's get started with today's topic list. Today is 24th of November. The first topic is new crypto bill seeks to ban the private player. Government is coming up with the new crypto bill. The second is India-US commit to linking economy across the sector. The third, Defense Acquisition Council has approved AK-203 deal with Russia. The second last, US measures to ease soaring oil prices. And the last is an editorial, MSP that rural India need is would be likely to call as maximum support policy. Right? This is an editorial from the Indian Express. Apart from this, at the end of this video, there would be some MCQ questions. These questions would be based on current affairs that will help you in the upcoming prelims examination. And if you want to practice a lot more important MCQ questions, we have test series for you. You will get 60 high quality tests in this particular test series with the subscription of IAS Gazette 12 month magazines. For more details, you can refer to the link which I have provided in the description section. You can directly redirect to the link which will help you to buy this particular set courses or test series. And if you're new to our channel, do not forget to subscribe AptiPlace Academy for Civil Services on YouTube. If you like this video, if you find this video helpful, do not forget to give a like button. Starting with the first news of the day, new crypto bill seeks to ban the private player, something which is important for General Studies Paper 2. Government policies and intervention for the development of various sectors. So we'll understand this news in detail, what exactly is there. So what government has announced, the central government has announced that they would be tabling the cryptocurrency and regulation of official digital currency bill in the coming winter session, which would be starting very soon, right? The government decide kiya hai ki ek nayi bill lai jayegi jahan pe cryptocurrency ya kisi bhi tarike ke digital currencies ko regulate kiya jayega. So the bill seeks to ban all private cryptocurrencies within few exception. Because of this, ये decision के बाद, ये news आने के बाद, बहुत सारी cryptocurrencies की जो market है, I mean globally अगर बात करें cryptocurrency की जो market है, वो deteriorate हुई है. However, following the government proposals, the value of major digital currencies have dropped significantly. Bitcoin की अगर बात करें, specifically Bitcoin और Ether have lost the most. The crypto bill is a part of 26th bill that government of India planned to introduce this winter session. Almost government has 26th bill plan ki hai is winter session ke liye. Among that is one of the cryptocurrencies regulation and official digital currency bill. This is something which is important for your prelims examination also. So iske jo basics jo draft bill aayenge, then we'll discuss that also. Prelims ke liye kafi important hogi. Now, looking at the background of this, the government was planning to ban all cryptocurrencies last year. Government ne aisa decide kiya tha ki seedhe taur pe, in first instances, they have sought that each and every cryptocurrency would be banned in India. But kuch planning ki gai. The bill was introduced during the this year budgets only. And the bill was scrapped. The committee was formed to discuss the matter further with the stakeholders. Government of India ne pehle bill ko kharij karne se pehle ye socha, there need to be have a discussion. If the concern has been raised, we'll see and accordingly the rules and laws will be formulated. So since then, it has given a hint that cryptocurrencies can coexist with Indian rupee but might be regulated in the country under the supervision of the Apex Bank, that is the Reserve Bank of our country. Now, if you talk about the country which already recognizes the Bitcoin or cryptocurrency, there's only one country, that is El Salvador, the only country to give the cryptocurrency the status of legal tender. We have discussed this in detail, jahan pe crypto city banane ki baat ki gayi thi El Salvador ki taraf se. Now, some concerns that were raised by the RBI on Bitcoins. The RBI has titled the critical of Bitcoins and cryptocurrencies. And only few days back, jo RBI ki governor hai, he underlined the concerns regarding the cryptocurrencies, calling them a threat to the financial system. Because in India, the basically financial inclusions ki baat kare, financial literacy ki baat kare, people actually are not aware of that. Hamare yahan compared to West countries se financial literacy kam hai. So this is something which call for a more robust regulation under the RBI supervision. And RBI governor said that the cryptocurrency are serious threat to microeconomics and financial stability, jahan pe it can double the number of investors trading them and as well as claim the market value, right? So these are some of the concerns that were raised by the RBI concerning the Bitcoins and cryptocurrencies. Now, pilot project ki agar baat kare to Reserve Bank of India ne, they're looking to launch a pilot project on the official digital currency soon, and the bill seeks to prohibit any private player on the cryptocurrency. So this has been categorically specified in the bill in terms of government intention, and RBI is also not backing any private player to come into the crypto market. However, it allows certain exceptions to promote the underlying technology of cryptos and its users. See, agar technology ki baat kare, technology upgradations ki baat kare, to wahan pe hame private players ki zarurat padegi. But in terms of regulation, the whole and soul would be regulated by the Reserve Bank or any other body that would be constituted under the bill by the government of India, right? So how common is crypto? You can see this graph, you map basically. आप इसमें देख सकते हैं कौन कौन से कंट्रीज हैं जिन्होंने ऑलमोस्ट लीगलाइज किया हुआ है. सो नाइजीरिया, वियतनाम, फिलीपींस, टर्की, पेरू, स्विट्जरलैंड, इंडिया परसेंटेज विथ 9%, चाइना, यूएस, जर्मनी एंड जापान. सो रिस्पोंडेंट अक्रॉस कंट्रीज दैट हैव सम फॉर्म ऑफ क्रिप्टो करेंसी इन द पास्ट वन ईयर. सो दिस इज अ ग्राफ विच साइट्स द रिजल्ट्स फॉर द पास्ट वन ईयर एंड दिस डेटा हैज बीन टेकन फ्रॉम स्टैटिक्स ग्लोबल कंज्यूमर सर्वे. Now, the second news, India-US commit to link economy across the sector. Yesterday also, we had a discussions regarding the US FTA representative coming to India. Ye usi ki advanced version ya fir jo conclusion nikle hai, uski follow-up news hai. And this become again important. Koi bhi aisi meetings India mein hoti hai, to aksar Hindu mein aapko uske follow-up news milte hai next day. So today, some important point that is relevant for the examination, we'll see that. This is important for General Studies Paper 2, Bilateral Regional Grouping and Agreement, Evolving India's and Affecting India's Interest. So in the recent Trade Policy Forum, which was held in New Delhi, both United States and India has said its commitment to integrate the economies across the sector to harness and tap the potential of bilateral relationship between India and United States. It's a trade forum that takes economic ties between two countries in the next high level exchange view with the potential target and tariff reductions. Kuch action plan ki baat ki gayi, we'll see the detail about this also. Our infograph is also waiting for you. So dono side ne wait kiya hai, they have decided to activate the working group of trade forum. Chahe wo agriculture ki baat ho, non-agriculture goods, services, investment, intellectual property right, also known as IPR right. And frequently baat hoti rahi hai and address the issues of mutual concerns and beneficiaries for the both countries. The idea is to deliver tangible benefits to the farmer and business community, where both country would be looking forward for and resolutions to market access issues, right? Yesterday also we had a discussion regarding the market access, but after this basically ye trade policy forum ki jo meeting hui hai, the government of India is getting a clarity from the US end also. So this infograph, a lot more information here. The booster ties, the Indo-US trade policy forum decide to take economic tie to the next level. Aur kuch category wise discussion ki gayi thi. First is about the market access. Second is hope for the IT work, action plan and post-COVID plan. So agar market access ki baat kare, so kuch Indian seeks to have easy access to its mangoes, grapes, pomegranate, or US seeks to quid pro the cherries, pork and other products like alfalfa hay. Action plan ki baat kare, working group on agriculture and agriculture, non-agriculture goods, services would be meeting frequently. Jo IT workers hai, India US to restart talks on agreement to how to help professional, chahe wo H1B visa ki baat ho, ya bhi aur bhi kuch statutory provisions ho, social security contributions ki baat ho, now India and US would be working together. Post-COVID plan, both sides to work with the allies to secure the pharmaceutical manufacturing base in our country. Although India has been showing in inclinations towards having an Atmanirbhar pharmaceutical or manufacturing of domestic produce in our country, right? म्यूचुअल मार्केट एक्सेस की अगर बात करें तो फोरम हैड डिसाइडेड, जैसे मैंने आपको बताया, मैंगोज, ग्रेप्स, पोमग्रेनेट और ये सारी चीज़ें जो हैं इंडियन मार्केट से यूएस में आएंगी और यूएस मार्केट से कुछ चीज़ें इंडियन में जाएंगी। सो द लिस्ट इज हियर। नाउ रिस्टोरेशन ऑफ द जीएसपी बेनिफिट्स की बात की गई, जो जनरलाइज सिस्टम ऑफ प्रेफरेंस है दैट बेनिफिट्स बाय द यूएसएस एंड सेट टू हेल्प इंडस्ट्रीज फ्रॉम बोथ साइड इंटीग्रेटिंग द सप्लाई चेन इफेक्टिवली। एंड यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स नोटेड दैट इट इज सुटेबल फॉर द कंसिडरेशंस एंड ऑफिशियल स्टेटमेंट देयर सेड दैट दे आर लुकिंग फॉर सम प्रेफरेंसेज दैट कैन बी गिवन टू इंडिया व्हिच वाज एक्चुअली नॉट देयर ड्यूरिंग द प्रीवियस प्रेसिडेंशियलशिप। एंड द फोरम हैज ऑल्सो एग्रीड टू significance the negotiation of social security totalizations agreement in the interest of worker for both sided pursuing further engagement for far reaching in agreements. Now the other news, that is Defense Acquisition Council approve AK-203 deal with Russia, something which is important for General Studies paper 2 India and its neighborhood relation. Uske alawa ye aapka General Studies paper 3 जहाँ पे इंटरनल सिक्योरिटी और मिलिट्री एडवांसमेंट की बात की गई है वहाँ पे इम्पोर्टेंट है। सो रिसेंटली द डिफेंस एक्विजिशन काउंसिल विच इज बीइंग हेडेड बाय द डिफेंस मिनिस्टर दे हैव बेसिकली अप्रूव्ड अ लॉन्ग पेंडिंग डील जहाँ पे 6.71 लाख ऑफ AK-203 राइफल्स जो हैं वो मैन्युफैक्चर की जाएंगी। AK वर्जन्स ऑफ राइफल इज देयर इन इंडिया, मोस्ट फेमस इज AK-47 and AK-56, right? Now the number has increased up to 203, which is against the advanced version. So this decision was taken ahead of the Russian president coming to India to attend the India-Russia annual summit, right? Or inaugural bhi honi hai 2+2 ministerial dialogue between India and Russia. So another area likely to progress is the S very short range defense system or KA 2260 यूटिलिटी हेलीकॉप्टर के बारे में इस बार ये अनलाइकली है ये क्लियर हो पाएगी, बट अगेन दिस इज ऑल्सो अ पॉइंट ऑफ कंसर्न फॉर इंडिया। सो दिस इज अ मॉडल ऑफ AK-206, आप देख सकते हो अर्लियर इट लुक वेरी सिमिलर टू बेसिकली 203 जो AK-47 से बहुत हद तक मिलती जुलती है, राइट। नाउ इंटर गवर्नमेंटल एग्रीमेंट्स, the two countries have signed the intergovernmental agreements on February 2019, and this was between the Indo-Russian Rifle Private Limited, which would be setting up their industries in Korba, Uttar Pradesh, and the joint venture is between the Ordnance Factory Board from Indian side and Robots on Export and Kalsinova on Russian side, right? So this is how the manufacturing and the production will take place in India itself. एयरफोर्स सैटेलाइट के लिए भी एडवांसमेंट की गई है। तो डिफेंस एक्विजिशन काउंसिल ने प्रपोज किया फॉर प्रोक्योरमेंट ऑफ GSAT-7C कम्युनिकेशन सैटेलाइट फॉर इंडियन एयरफोर्स एट द कॉस्ट ऑफ 2,236। तो कुछ कुछ इंपॉर्टेंट जो एडवांसमेंट की जा रही है इंटरनल सिक्योरिटी डिफेंस एडवांसमेंट के लिए वो आपको पता होनी चाहिए। इवन इफ यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर CAPF एग्जामिनेशन दीज टाइप ऑफ न्यूज इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। इंडक्शन ऑफ GSAT-7C सैटेलाइट on the ground to hope our software defined radios will enhance the abilities of armed forces to communicate beyond the line of segment among the other circumstances to secure mode. Now US measures to ease soaring oil prices, something which is important for General Studies paper 2, effect of policies and politics for developed and developing countries. So the US president has ordered the release of 550 million barrel of oil from the US strategic reserve in a coordinated attempt with other countries to tamp the soaring the oil prices. जिस तरह से oil prices बढ़ रही है तो US ने कहा है वो 50 million barrel जो है वो contribute करेंगी जैसे कि और countries कर रही है। So this is a release which taken in parallel to the other major economy consuming the oil that include China, India, Japan, Republic of Korea and United Kingdom. So this is for the first time that the US is doing something like this in parallel to the other countries. बात करें कोविड के बाद जिस तरह से ऑयल की प्राइजेस में फ्रीक्वेंटली अप एंड डाउन देखे गए, सो ऑयल प्रोडक्शन हैज नॉट केप्ट इन पेस विद द रॉकेटिंग डिमांड पुशिंग अप द प्राइजेस। एंड एवरेज फ्यूल प्राइजेस की अगर बात करें, दे आर फिलिंग स्टेशन आर ऑलमोस्ट 3.41 गैलन हाइएस्ट सिंस 2014. And at the output rise, oil prices are already down nearly 10% in the past few weeks. So this is a present context, the global scenario about the crude oil prices in the country, India as well as the globally. MSP that rule India needs maximum support policy. This is an editorial from the Indian Express, important for General Studies Paper 3, policy related to direct and indirect farm subsidies, public distribution system, revamping buffer stocks and food security. So what is there in this editorial? Three important subheads. I will start first with the background and see how the sustainable agricultures will be doing. So intervention that would be required by the government and the way forward. And the theme of this editorial is need for the policy on minimum support price. So, अगर बात करें जो minimum support price है वो एक ऐसी issues है that has been continuing since we have got our independence, जहाँ से farm produce start हुई, basically जो अब green revolution से पहले ही MSP के बारे में बातें होती चल रही हैं, but the negotiation has never reached to a proper conclusion. और इस बार के जो farm protest में खास करके जो थी दो सबसे बड़ी demand थी farmers की, first demand was to abrogate the three laws that was made by the government, although इसको Supreme Court ने stay किया था. Second was to formulate a particular law, a specific law giving a legal backing to the minimum support price, right? So that is a demand still pending. Let's see what government is coming up in this winter session. And much of the rural India has largely been neglected for economically while being manipulated for the voters. Sustainable agricultures की बात की गई है, marketing and distributions of agriculture produce cannot be a panacea for the element inflicting on rural India, जहाँ पे political parties सिर्फ ये sustainability या फिर policies के लिए, votes के लिए इस issues को बना करके रखे हुए हैं. Instead, एक combination of regional involvement की ज़रूरत है, जहाँ पे sustainable agricultures की development की जाए, that can also lead to the deteriorations in the social inequality that is there, right? Such as bonded labor intensities made amendable to the new climatic trend that is required. Now, kuch important interventions ki zarurat padegi government ke end se to ensure ki jo government ki commitment hai, doubling of farm income, ensuring technology upgradations to the farmer, these things are met, but ये सारी चीज़ें को met करने से पहले एक intention चाहिए होगी, एक attitude चाहिए होगी government की that they are doing. So if government is concerned about the small and marginal farmer, the policy need to ensure for the equitable distribution of resources, land and water, access to the range of alternative economic practices, as well as support structure must also be framed. So if you're writing in mains paper, आप इस तरह के points ज़रूर include करेंगे. Instead of subsidies that largely goes to non-rural beneficiaries, moratorium ki jo options jo COVID mein li gayi thi pandemic ke time mein, that is something very important for the farmers, right? And comprehensive program on this line would enable not only a transitions to sustainable agriculture, but also enable people to develop climate changes mitigation, adaptation and strategies. कुछ वे फॉरवर्ड की अगर बात करें, क्या कंक्लूजन हो सकती है अपार्ट फ्रॉम फार्मर, वॉट else can be done, no? Basically government interventions kis tarah se strengthen karne ki zarurat hai, that this is getting to the grassroots of the farmers. So supporting farmers for farm collective, which is a resource, labor skill, knowledge, ye sare pool mein hame value additions karne ki zarurat hai, and that go a long way in correcting multiple ways which can exclude the profit or gains. And a new seed policy which focuses on enabling the local seed bank, help farmer to circumvent the problematic commercial seeds and industry would be essential. Now, rural India required a new economic deal that addresses the past mistake and heal the wound that caused by the year neglecting the healthcare, education and other avenues to enhance the quality of life. Aur aakhri mein, it need to have a revive of health of the soil, water and resources to provide employment for the people of this country, for the farmers, and enhance the quality of life, right? So, agar agriculture mein basically upgradations nahi hai, employment nahi hai, so people, what they're doing, jo non-farm sectors mein hai, khas kar wo chahte hain, unko formal economy mein employment mile, policies agar us tarah se nahi hai, to wo majboor hai wapas se farming mein jane ke liye. So, government need to have a view, jahan pe ek taraf se agriculture ko bhi boost kiya jaye, aur kuch log jo, no, जो सोशल सिक्योरिटी स्कीम्स या फिर जो फॉर्मल इकोनॉमी में जुड़ना चाहते हैं उन लोगों के लिए भी कुछ पॉलिसीज लेकर के आए. सो दिस इज हाउ द वे फॉरवर्ड कैन बी कंक्लूडेड. Now moving to the MCQ questions of the day, before I proceed, just to tell you the answers of yesterday questions. For first question, the correct option is C. For the second question, the correct option is B. Today's MCQ, National Science Day celebrated every year to commemorate the discovery of Newton law. Aur is baar ki theme thi, F future for STI, science, technology and innovation, impact on education, skill and work. So if you know the answer, do let me know in the comment section. अगर आपको कुछ क्वेश्चंस में अलग वेरिएंट चाहिए, अलग तरह के क्वेश्चंस चाहिए, तो वो भी आप हमें कमेंट सेक्शन में बता सकते हैं। नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशन रैंकिंग फ्रेमवर्क के बारे में बतानी है आपको। नीति आयोग एस्टैब्लिश द नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशन रैंकिंग फ्रेमवर्क। दिस फ्रेमवर्क वॉज बेसिकली एन आउटलाइन फॉर द मेथडोलॉजी टू रैंक इंस्टीट्यूशन अक्रॉस द कंट्री। रिसेंटली भी रिलीज की गई थी। आई थिंक मोस्ट ऑफ यू मस्ट बी अवेयर ऑफ द करेक्ट आंसर। सो लेट मी नो हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू नो द करेक्ट आंसर। राइट योर आंसर इन द कमेंट सेक्शन डाउन बिलो। This was all about the daily news and editorial analysis followed by the MCQs. If you have any other concern, you can let me know in the comment section down below. We'll be more than happy to assist you. For time being, I'm signing off. Thank you so much for watching.